Hi, good morning to everyone. You know, by precisely controlling duty cycle, pulse width, and frequency, modern day inverters can convert DC power to AC power very efficiently. Inverters are used for various applications such as solar power systems, electric vehicles, and uninterruptible power supplies, which are commonly known as UPS. In addition, inverter is an important part used in a variable frequency drive to control the speed of the motor. First, let's look at how the voltage across a load can be reversed when using a DC supply. This is an H-bridge and is probably an electronic circuit that changes the polarity of a voltage applied to a load. The name is derived from four switching elements configured as the branches of the letter H, and the load is connected as the crossbar. Let's introduce a mid-zero ammeter onto the load to check the direction of the current flow. When S1 and S4 switches are closed, current flows from left to the right side of the load. Also, when S2 and S3 are closed, current path of the load reverses and flows from right to the left side now. These circuits are often used in robotics and other similar applications to allow DC motors to run forward or backward. On the graph on the right side, you can see how the current flow direction changes depending on the switching frequency. If both switches on the same arm are closed simultaneously, it would create a direct path for current to flow from the positive supply to the negative supply bypassing the load. This would result in a short circuit, which could damage the circuit and cause excessive current to flow. To ensure this does not happen, the control logic of the H-bridge switches ensure that when one switch on one arm is closed, the other switch on that same arm is open. By correct controlling of these switches alternately, the direction of the current through the load can be controlled to the perfection, avoiding a short circuit. Let's see how the single-phase AC voltage sinusoidal wave behaves. Frequency of this supply voltage is 50 Hertz. Also note that, in North America and some other countries, the supply frequency is 60 Hertz. Frequency is the number of complete cycles performed in 1 second. Period or periodic time is the time consumed to complete one sinusoidal cycle. Therefore, to find the periodic time, divide 1 second by the number of cycles performed in a second. So the periodic time of this voltage cycle is 0.02 seconds, or 20 milliseconds. Let's consider half of this voltage cycle now. Time consumed for this half sine wave cycle is 0.01 seconds, or 10 milliseconds. Also, you need to know that this sine wave cycle is an analog signal. When we consider transforming DC voltage to AC voltage, you need to know about analog signals and digital signals. Typically, an analog signal is a continuous signal and represents data as a continuous waveform. It can take any value within a time range and can have an infinite number of possible values over a period of time, like the values in a sine wave. A digital signal is different and represents data as a sequence of separate signals, like the on and off signals, generated with a set of switches. Digital signals are commonly used in computers and electronic devices such as inverters, and they can be easily processed, stored, and transmitted. Inverter is used to transform stable DC voltage into AC alternating voltage by methodical use of digital signals. But you should know that the generated sine wave is not a completely smooth curve, like the one generated with analog signals. Let's see how digital signals are generated here. First, divide this half wavelength to 4 equal parts, and one part represents one switching cycle. Switching will be on and off position only, and the switch on position here is 325 volts DC supply. Consider the H-bridge discussed previously, and on position means S1 and S4 switches are closed, and the off position means when those two switches are opened. Let's keep switches S2 and S3 open for the time being. Periodic time of the switching cycle is 2.5 milliseconds, since we have 4 switching cycles over the period of 10 milliseconds. Let's keep the switches on for the first half of the cycle, and off for the next half of the cycle. Duty cycle is the percentage on time of the periodic time of the switching cycle. So here in this first switching cycle, duty cycle is 50%. Pulse width is the time duration of the duty cycle, and is simply the switch on time of the switching cycle. Here the pulse width is 1.25 milliseconds. Frequency is the number of switching cycles performed in 1 second. So divide 1 second by periodic time in seconds, you get the frequency of switching cycle. Make sure the millisecond value of the period has been converted to seconds, since the numerator, or top part of this equation, is also in seconds. So divide 1 by 0.0025 seconds, you get 400 Hz as the frequency. Let's see a different switching time now. Although the frequency remains constant here, duty cycle is 25% now. That means, switches are at off position during 75% of the periodic time. Then the pulse width also reduced to 0.625 milliseconds now. If you check the voltage across the load now, 325 volts has become a half of that during the first 2 cycles, and is 25% of that voltage when duty cycle is 25%. So the DC supply voltage can be varied by modulating or controlling the pulse width of the switching cycle. This is called pulse width modulation, or PWM, and it provides a flexible and efficient method of simulating a near-perfect analog output using digital signals. Also note that, to make these voltage changes to happen, by changing the duty cycle, you need to provide very short pulses by operating the on and off switches extremely fast. Pulse width should be around 0.05 milliseconds, or 50 microseconds, to make these voltage changes to occur. To produce pulses that small, you need to have a switching frequency of around 20 kHz, that is 20,000 Hz. So to get these very small pulses, without any short circuit issues, you should use IGBT switches for your H-bridge circuit. IGBT stands for Insulated Gate Bipolar Transistor. Out of the 3 pins on it, C is the collector, and is to be connected to the positive side of the DC circuit. E is the emitter, and is to be connected to the negative side, or to the ground. G is the gate, and when positive voltage is applied to this gate, it will create a conductive channel between collector and emitter, allowing current to flow through the channel. A commonly used switching frequency for medium power inverters is 20 kHz. Periodic time for 20 kHz switching cycle is 50 microseconds, and is effectively achievable with these type of IBGT switches. To produce an AC sinusoidal waveform, we need to reverse the voltage and the current flow through the load, alternately. To generate the positive side values, we close S1 and S4 switches. For the negative side values, S2 and S3 must be closed. Here, in the second switching cycle, negative side voltage is generated by closing the pair of switches, S2 and S3. Third switching cycle is also on the reverse side, but with 25% duty cycle. Fourth cycle is on the positive side, with a 100% duty cycle. Voltage values generated using pulse width modulation of 4 switching cycles are shown here, in red. Although the switching operation and the generated voltage are shown here on the same graph, they can be shown on 2 separate graphs for ease of understanding. Here in this graph, periodic time of voltage cycle is divided into 24 switching cycles, to enable smoother curve generation using digital signals. So the periodic time of switching cycle is given by periodic time of voltage cycle divided by number of switching cycles during one voltage cycle. It is 0.83 milliseconds, and the frequency of the switching cycle is 1200 Hz. Also, by multiplying supply voltage, frequency, and number of switching cycles together, you get the switching cycle frequency. So by modulating pulse widths of these 24 switching cycles of 1.2 kHz, you get this waveform, but still it is not that close to the smooth sine wave shown originally. You can now understand that, by selecting switching cycles with a much higher frequency around 20 kHz, much smoother curve can be generated, and it will be very close to the sine wave generated with an analog signal. I hope now you have a clear idea about duty cycle, pulse width and frequency, and also how pulse width modulation works to create a smooth sine wave curve using digital signals. If this video is useful, please subscribe to the channel. Thank you.